Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to our Bioshock 2 Let's Replay series, where we try to delve a bit deeper into the story and the secrets of this game. So I set up a nice wall of traps on both sides of this area. I'm gonna try and hide around here somewhere while the little sister gathers Adam. We have a camera over there, so that's the reason why the trap rivets are a bit lighter on that spot, and I can shock that pool of water over there if needs be. So now that we actually have pots already, I'm gonna just go ahead and gather Adam.
Let's get it.
There we go.
Family, that monster has taken a number of our babies for his own. Tin's daddy is hollow like a jail cell that needs filling, and he will never let her go unless you hunt him down.
So Grace Holloway antagonizes the splicers in this place to start attacking me. They're coming from the left as well, I'm starting to hear, so I'm just gonna let them approach, because I'm bad at range at the moment, so if they can get closer. I think there's someone coming from behind us here as well. There we go. Starting to run out of trap rivets. Don't know what happened over there. I think something exploded. So just gonna take her, pick her up, because that's gonna freeze the splicer. There we go, in the face. We still have a few trap rivets left, which is really nice as well. So done. Now that we have a bit of extra Adam, the first thing I'm gonna do is actually check out the Gatherer's Garden for that armored shell we've been eyeing up since the previous episode. So let's just do that really quickly. During these ambushes, the corpses of the splicers also tend to disappear a lot more quickly, just because there are so many of them. And the game doesn't seem to be able to keep them in memory. So there we go. We do already have the upgrade for Electrobolt 2. So now we can stun multiple opponents with the power of Chain Lightning, which is really, really good. We're going to have to wait with that, because there's a lot of extra stuff here. Eve Saver is another really, really good one. So Plasma to use less Eve. Telekinesis 2 allows you to throw harder for more damage. But the first thing we're going to get is Armored Shell. Useful in any hazardous situation, Armored Shell offers automatic protection against life's bumps and bruises. Don't be a softie, use Armored Shell now. So reduces all physical damage. I think I'm going to go for Booze Hound to remove that one. I'm going to have to take that into account. Quiets your footsteps, Drill Lurker should be nice, but not something we're going to need right now. There we go. So let's keep it like that for now. We're going to have a lot more Adam later on, but we're going to have to wait with that. Remote Hack Dart. And then Ryan versus Lamb, another one of the debates. So let's listen to that.
Religious rites, Doctor. You're free to kneel before whatever tribal fetish you favor in the comfort of your own home. But in Rapture, liberty is our only law. A man's only duty is to himself. To imply otherwise, therefore, is criminal.
Ask yourself, Andrew, what is your great chain of progress but a faith? The chain is a symbol for an irrational force guiding us towards ascension. No less mystic than the crucifixes you seize and burn.
So there we go, a bit of a debate about religion, about whether we should force religion or not upon the people. Okay, there we go. And we should go into the Sinclair Deluxe, so Sinclair's hotel, where he got kicked out of because Grace Holloway kicked him out of it. We have a road over here, but it's blocked. I don't think there's anything there, except for a little message. I think Rapture's There is no escape. Never mind. So, what's this? Skid Row. Skid Row. So I think one of the areas in Pauper's Drop is called Skid Row. So, Unity and Metamorphosis. And a lot of propaganda for Sophia Lamb's office. You are not alone, Sophia Lamb, M.D. But, let's see. Can we make a reservation, please? We can actually search the desk from here. Can we get that wrong side of the tracks?
Old Papa's Drop's the worst neighborhood in Rapture. But it's a hell of an opportunity to raise up some affordable housing.
Well, sport, I guess Gracie's home. But that big lug just dropped half my damn hotel in your way. Now, to break through that mess, I expect you're gonna have to work out how he got so burly.
So you can already feel it coming?
Find yourself a genetic research camera, son. You can pick up any number of tricks from a splicer with one of those. Try the pawn shop downtown.
So there we go, the introduction of the research camera, which will work a bit different than it did in the previous game. Also, by the way, we can carry more than $500, it appears, in this game. Kind of forgot about that. So one of those big splicers, that really big bulky splicers, just tossed a lot of debris in our way. And we need to investigate the big splicer just so we could, be as strong as that guy is. So, I think I still have an auto-hack dart, so let's shoot it with that. And check this out, press the anti-personnel rounds, first aid kits and dollars, which is really, really good. Let's go with the rivets. I do like to shoot with rivets. Kind of cool because in the entire first game you were looking at Rosie's carrying one of these. And you couldn't shoot it, but now we can. So another dead splicer, nothing too particular about it. Let's see in the cupboards if anything is there. Does seem like it. A bit more ammo. Oh, and heavy rivets. Heavy rivets. So good against armored targets. So if we get another big sister in our way, we can just blast it with those. So drill fuel over there. Don't really need that right now. And we need to get a research camera. So we just nipped into the hotel to see if we could go through, but the big splicer just blocked our way. Because the hotel is also the place where Grace Holloway is located, so we still need to go over there.
I suppose that now I know who my true friends were.
Sounds like she's just over there. I'm just gonna ignore her. There we go, a few headshots to that guy. Takes care of everything. I do like that we can carry more ammo right now. Seems like a nice cream-filled cake over here. Oh, yeah, and there's a little sister vent, so we can rescue and harvest already. But we still have one more corpse to go. Let's see. Hello? Anybody here? So the pawn shop is right over there. Hello? So that's a bit of damage already.
I'm gonna save you, mate.
Is he gonna attack me already? Yeah, okay, he is. There we go. Let's keep him interested. So I think he's gonna walk into the oil slick. Okay, let's go with heavy rivets. Oh no, you don't. Where's he going? Oh shit. Oh, there he is again. Oh, I just shot them too late. Oh, nope. Let's hack this thing really quickly. That was bad. Oh, he actually healed a lot from that. Jesus Christ, can I drill this guy to death? Ooh, that's gonna hurt. Let's destroy this. Oh god, this guy is annoying. Can I drill this guy to death? Seems like I can. There we go. taken care of like a real big daddy in your face. Brute splicer, $2, $26, and a few trap rivets. But we are out of supplies. I think we get a first aid kit from this thing. I'm going to have to scrounge for supplies a bit. So there's the research camera. You can see it over there. So we need to get on the roof and drop in through that hole over there that the brute splicer just made. This is just a vital chamber where those extra splices came from. No biggie. Anything else you guys might carry? That actually took half of my fuel as well. Let's just take a quick look around. So this is actually straight to the diner again. Thank you for that. And I don't think, because we could break locks.
Use that code you found on the keypad outside the clinic. Should get you up on the rooftops.
Okay, I didn't see any code I found, but did I find the code? Code 10047, apparently. Don't really realize where I saw that code, but apparently I did. So, okay then. I'm just gonna check out this thing, because I'm full of money, but I don't really have any supplies left. There we go, and there we go. So 50 caliber rounds and Eve hypo. And then of course, first aid kits. A lot of first aid kits. Ooh, we can actually buy heavy rivets. Thank you for that. That's gonna come in really, really handy, because the heavy rivets also work on the brute splicers. Rip Prentice Mill. End of the line.
This is it. It's over. I built this railroad from nothing. Played by Mr. Ryan's rules. But then he asks me to sink my own cash reserves into the banks to give Rapture some breathing room. And now... now Austin goddamn Bathysphere wants to buy me out. Decommission the entire rail. I have no family, and no time for friends. I am the Atlantic Express, and this is the end of the line.
So yeah, we can kind of assume he took his own life right here, because this is clearly his grave. And that was Prentice Mill, so the owner of the Atlantic Express railroad lines. There is another... another corpse over here. I do really want to try that out, but let's listen to this first. That's what I wanted to say.
What do they expect? You keep enough drug stash in this clinic to splice up a rhinoceros. Of course every poor soul in a drop's gonna start beating down your door. It's my job to think up a new key code to keep them out. Seems like every other day now. Nuts. I'll mull it over for a while at the Fishbowl Diner.
So I probably saw the code accidentally at the Fishbowl Diner, because it didn't really pop at me before that. I think I'm going to actually keep this closed, because if I can, that's a good way to keep the splices limited to a few areas they can come from. So let's put up a few more trap rivets. So let's put 6 on this side. A few more on this side of the wall. Let's spread them out a bit so they trigger one by one. And then the last two I'll probably put over there on the side, because they could be able to come from here as well. So there we go, last two. And then we should go with the anti-personnel rounds. I have a bit left. And then, of course, we have the shotgun as well, just in case if anything comes too close. So let's go with that. Here you go, little girl.
The monster has taken another of our children, family. He would turn her from us just as he did to Eleanor. Show this thing what befalls the boogeyman when he steps into our garden.
Just gonna be careful with my... So she's dead, okay. So that was wave one, probably. Well, I'm gonna have to switch weapons. And then one killed over there.
I can't stand him.
Do have to be careful. There we go.
Spectator, where'd you go, lover boy?
Okay, I think she's almost done. I think I'm gonna just... Oh, she exploded. Okay, yeah.
This angel's all done now. Yay!
Thank you for coming.
There we go. Did she just say thank you for coming? Yep. Pick up. I'm gonna take you right home. And there we have another bit of Adam, which is really, really cool. Okay, so we still have two trap rivets left over here. Let's take a quick look around. There we go. Ooh, and these ones didn't go... Where did those guys come from then? Because this door was locked. I kept this locked on purpose, but apparently they didn't care. You know what? I think, yeah, the little sister vent is over there, so let's put her... Let's rescue her right over there, so that we're done with that. We get 80 more Adam, right? Rescue. Goodbye, little girl. Have fun in the vent. Hopefully there aren't any giant mutated rats. Look at that. I think they really did a nice job with the normal little sisters in this game, because they still look kind of creepy in Bioshock 1, but here they look pretty good. Thank you for your cream-filled cake. Goodbye, little girl. Okay, so now we need to go find that research camera. I could actually... Maybe I should just check out the Gatherer's Garden first, since we're so close to it. See if we can't buy a bit of an upgrade. There we go. I think Grace Holloway just started to talk, but never mind. Ooh, let's think about this. I do want to upgrade Electro Bolt. The first really, really interesting one is Eve Safer. To take that, I'm gonna just buy a gene slot. There we go. Just put Booze Hound there for a second. Bought a slot. Ooh, that's actually... Is that a golden trophy? Wow. Trophy earned, that is. So that's by Eve Safer as well. It's gonna be really handy later on. So in today's genetic wonderland, you probably feel like there's never enough Eve at hand. With Eve Safer, your Eve will go farther than ever before. So instead of Booze Hound. And then we have a little left, but headshots do more damage. Is really nice if you can aim. But for now, I'm just gonna keep it at
now,
that.
Baby Snatcher, even after what you did to her, Dr. Lamb found a way to shape that girl into something perfect, something holy. She's a daughter to us all. Nobody in Rapture will shelter you now.
Grace has got the wrong idea. You're not responsible for turning Eleanor into a little sister. Big daddies are just slaves, and you only recently broke free.
So there we go, Sinclair, with a little bit of peace of mind. Because he assures us that we're not responsible for, turning Eleanor into a little sister, because the big daddies are just the slaves in this scenario. So, I've put it off way too long, so let's put in the code 0047. There we go. Open the door. And let's take the shotgun, because we're in a bit of tight corners here. And the music changes a bit to some kind of... I don't know what it's supposed to be. Kind of sounds like we're in a Western movie. Surprise? Surprise! Oh! That was a camera. So that's turned over there. So let's hack it. There we go. Camera for us. I think it's just referencing jazz right now, because Gracie Holloway is kind of a jazz singer. And kind of cliche, but she's also black, so black and jazz goes together as a... Well, pepper and salt, as they say. So let's take a look around. Yeah, okay. So that's bullets passing there. Let's hack it from over here. There we go. our turret. Let's see, because we have a bit of machine gun ammo left. And then someone came in behind me. They're gonna die. I don't really want to turn around anymore, because I know they're gonna die. Because I think it must be that the drones took out the Rosie for me and our first little sister. That was a mean shot. I do actually want a bolt. Can I? No. Where's it going? No, get over here. There we go. I wasn't able to boost it, but yeah, okay. One is better than none, I suppose. So there we have a turret that shot at us, and I think there's another corpse up here. But more importantly, I think this is the corpse that you can actually use for our little sister gathering. Anything in front of the sign doesn't look like it, which is kind of weird. Would expect there to be something. And then we have the hole we need to go down to. Ooh, that. Luckily, I didn't say the hole that I need to go down on. Just mean that we need to go down that hole. I'm just gonna shut up. There's another a lot of extra areas here as well, so I might just check those out first. Something in my eye. Tickles. Sorry. Some more heavy rivets, which are always handy. Ooh. Armor-piercing rounds. That is very, very nice. That was, yeah, 60 rounds of armor-piercing rounds. I love how quickly he switches between ammo types as well. So there's another camera, clearly. Okay, there we go. Switch too fast. Where's the... Oh. Can I... Oh, that was... Okay, why did that sound effect take so long? Jesus Christ, stop doing that, it's creepy. Why is it do- Oh, never mind. So she wasn't dead either, so that's why the crazy music was going. There was another ritual going on here, and they needed to blow my eardrums for that. So let's take the arrangements.
Now, Eleanor, Mommy has to go away for a while. You shall be staying with Aunt Gracie.
Mommy, don't go!
Eleanor, you are better than that. Do you remember what I told you?
I am very special.
That's right. And what else?
I was born to change the world.
Yes. And when Mummy returns home, the world will be very different indeed. She will make it ready for you.
There we go. So, while Sophia Lamb was making preparations, as far as we know, she put Eleanor in the care of Gracie Holloway, and that's the reason why Grace Holloway is so attached to Eleanor. So here we have another audio diary. They keep coming.
Another day, no clients. Atlas and Ryan start going at it hot and heavy, and all my business dries up. Used to be easy. Put the eye on some spliced up dame's wandering husband and rake in the dough. Now it's got so bad I had to put my camera and hawk at King Pond. Makes a guy consider splicing up himself. If I had two dimes to rub together, that is.
So Rock Flanagan, this private investigator we just found an audio diary of, is the actual owner of that research camera down there. So that's why I wanted to take a look in this area first. Moment, how did I go through this area now? Oh yeah, okay. So here's the power to the people station. And because his business dried up, he was forced to sell his camera, and that's why the camera is in the pawn shop right now. So, let's upgrade one of the weapons. Always a big choice now, isn't it? So shotgun damage would be nice. Let's go with the clip size is also very nice. So the double revolver mechanism allows 6 shots before reloading, which would actually make this gun a lot more, well, efficient. The other thing I'm struggling with is there's a really cool upgrade for the drill. So you can use the drill to deflect projectiles while you're drilling, which is really cool, but it requires me to buy the drill fuel efficiency upgrade first. And then the reflector, so I'm gonna wait with that and just gonna go for the shotgun clip size. So a double revolver mechanism. There we go. Look at that lovely thing. So now we can fire, if we reload, of course, 6 shots before reloading. Don't really need that. I have plenty of ammo left. Don't think there's anything over here. But just let's take a look around. The game just thinks I'm stuck, but I'm not really stuck. I just wanna be thorough. So this is another area where we went through, if I'm not mistaken. So yeah, excuse me, bot, go out of the way. Let's see, so we should drop down. Now, I said this before, there's another area over there we can enter now that we're on the roof, and there's clearly a lot of spices in this area as well. Hello. I think it's downstairs for some reason. Therapy with Grace. Oh, he activated the drone.
Sophia, I came down here to sing and to start a family, but I just don't fit with these people. Look at you. You fit with them.
Grace, in Ryan's rapture, I am the pariah. You and I share unpopular ideas, but I wonder, how devoted are you to the Rapture people? If you wish to know more, wear this butterfly brooch at our next session. If not, no harm done. We shall never speak of it again.
So a sort of secret handshake was proposed. So if the people were wearing that brooch on their next visit with Dr. Lam, they wanted to become part of Lam's family. So yeah, that's how she recruited people using her practice. So let's hack the door over here. 25 armor-piercing rounds and heavy rivets. We can clearly take out bigger enemies in a pinch right now. Let's see, because there's a lot of splices around here apparently, because they keep respawning for some reason. Let's use telekinesis. Ooh, thank you for the Eve hypo. And let's go for electrobolt, and let's take the research camera. So again, it's a weapon, but it works a bit different than in the previous game. So press R2 while focused on an enemy to start research on a target. So it starts research.
That thing's a miracle in Technicolor, kid. Works like a movie camera. Start the film rolling before you open fire on a splicer, and then anything you hit him with tells you more about his DNA. Let's give it a dry run, shall we?
So DNA was weirdly put in the subtitles over there, but I think they don't show a splicer outside of the windows as a start. Apparently they don't. So instead of taking pictures, you actually start a movie reel. And once you start the movie reel, you actually have the opportunity to start firing. The more different things you do, the better, excuse me, the better the score. Hello? Can I actually open the door? I don't really know that. There's a lot of vodka over here. Can I actually open the door? How do I open the door? Hello?
Okay. Easy now. Looks like you got the jump on this fella. Start your camera recording him. Then hit him with a little bit of everything. Plasmids, firearms, whatever you can dish out.
Okay, so here we go. Start the movie reel. And actually, he got startled by that. Let's hit him with electrobolt and hit him in the face. So, Tugger Spices increase damage. And they are vulnerable to anti-personnel rounds. So now we're going to start this thing all over again.
That's it, son. Camera spits out a prize once in a while as you learn.
There we go, same for the lead head splicers.
Now, find one of those big old brutes and take them out on film. Before long, you'll be able to brush aside that mess at the hotel.
There we go, so A+. So as long as you do something different than the previous attempt, you actually gain points. Okay, that was actually nicely ducked from that lady. Hello. And then take the shotgun. That was an A. So that encourages you a bit to be creative when killing your enemies. Provided you actually start research on them before you do. So now we need to find one of those brute splices. We checked up on everything upstairs. We do need to return over there once we find the another little sister. But for now, let's continue on. So Skid Row or Sinclair Deluxe. We don't need to go to Sinclair Deluxe. But we do need to go to Skid Row to find ourselves one of those brute splicers.
Using that camera is a bit like telling a joke. Each time you tell it the same way, it gets a little more stale. So you gotta change it up to keep it fresh.
So there we go. We have a few splicers fighting a big daddy. I'm gonna start research on the lady over there. And start firing at her. There we go. That was just a B just because we simply shot at it. And I think, is that a splicer? Yes, it is. Okay, that was security. I think I just started research on security. Hello, fella. So I think it stops automatically after a while as well, so don't really need to I think it stops automatically. Can I actually just stop it? Can't really stop it. I do want to take out the big daddy. Ooh, that might be a... So now we have another target, so let's light her up. And now we're just gonna blast her a bit with machine gun fire. A plus, simple as that. Just be careful to start research the moment you encounter them. There we go. Ooh, A plus. There we go. So every once in a while we're gonna get a reward just the same as we did with the images. The photos. Okay. Take it easy. There we go. Eve hypo. And then we have the remote hack dart. Let's see what's in here. Could we use anything in here? Not right now. Another thing that's gonna come in handy. So we have a little sister right now. So he just pulled her out of the... Oh, shut the camera. Kinda missed that camera over there. Okay, there we go. Our camera. And now I actually wanna move things up a bit. Because we are really close to everything really... Oh, sardines. We want to have the gas canister over there. And now let's... You need to be careful. So do we have telekinesis? Oh, this is going to be bad. There we go. Level reached. So increased damage against the Rosie and Big Daddies. Oh, it's Big Daddies in general. So Big Daddies are friendly with armor piercing rounds. There we go, and then we should go for heavy rivets. There we go. Oh, what just happened? I think we got blasted by a nitro splicer. Yeah, okay, so there's a lot of explosions going on. Let's take the research camera. Oh! That was not what I wanted to do. Do we actually get a score for... that was a miss, right? Yeah, that was a mess. So, a little sister, I'm gonna come to your aid in a sec. Ah, shit. Okay, just take it easy. There we go. Oh, and that actually gives us... Ooh, that's actually good to know. Security. That took a bit of our supplies, but now, of course, we have another little sister at our disposal.
I'm telling the other girls that I have the best dad.
Goodbye. A plus. Hello. Sorry I needed to kill that woman right in front of you, little girl, but two first aid kits, that was actually really, really generous of you. Well, generous as you can be since you're dead, so I'm gonna buy a few more supplies over here. Because I think we're out of pretty much everything right now. Let's see, ooh, there's a lot of areas in this place. I remember this place. Pauper's Drop is a maze. Let's take a look in here. Apparently, there is another way here, but I don't want to miss anything.
I wish I could publish this stuff. It's newsman pay dirt. Sinclair says Ryan's making a move against Sophia Lamb, and they want to cut me in on the action. They're building a case that Lamb's a closet pinko, sort of an undercover thing. So, I cozy up to this guy Wales, who works for Lamb.
Oh, for fuck's
sake.
Remember,
son, without using that research camera, we can't get to Gracie. And that means we're stuck here. Get one of those big apes on film, then work him over.
Yeah, thank you, Sinclair. We were listening to your former colleague.
I wish I could publish this stuff. It's newsman pay dirt. Sinclair says Ryan's making a move against Sophia Lamb, and they want to cut me in on the action. They're building a case that Lamb's a closet pinko, sort of an undercover thing. So I cozy up to this guy Wales, who works for Lamb, making like I want to join up. Then I find out whether he grew his beard for Jesus or Karl Marx.
So there we go, another character is implied here. So Wales is someone working for Sophia Lamb as well, and Stanley Poole was trying to frame both of them to, give Ryan a reason to arrest them. So, another one.
This Lamb woman's powers of manipulation are almost scary. Her people are using the girls from the surface to gather Adam from Lamb's followers. It's in the blood. And eventually they give themselves over. Like dying is an honor. I'd almost feel sorry for them if they didn't have my daughter. I'm going to find Lamb and take Cindy back one way or another.
So there we go. Mark Meltzer, our friend, looking for his daughter. I'm just going to buy an extra remote Hagdar just in case. So yeah, there's another interesting detail that Mark just mentions. So we already knew that Sophia Lamb recreated the little sisters to get more Adam, but we never really know what she wants with the Adam. Because, it's not clearly power. She has some other alternative motives. So there's another brute splicer, by the way. So Mark also mentions that the followers of Sophia are willing to die for Sophia Lamb, and not just dying, but the sacrifice is worth something because it's in the blood. So even her followers are willing to die just to give Sophia Lamb more Adam. And the reason why they're so eager to do that is actually a bigger part of the story, so I'm not going to tell you yet. I'm just going to take a look upstairs. Can we actually go? No. But is there something we can telekinesis from here? Apparently not. So let's take a look up here. Whack this thing before anybody makes use of it. Oh, hi. Ooh, that was a heavy rivet I didn't want to use. Sometimes it's really fidgety in how it actually selects these things. So there we go. There we go. Let's dance with him, daddy. Indeed, let's dance with them. So here's another corpse. I think as with the previous episode, just gonna check this out, Sunday services, and after that we're gonna take a little break.
Been hearing rumors. Sounds like somebody named Wales is starting up worship services down in Siren Alley, believe it or not. All faiths and creeds welcome, they says. They got big promises, salvation, immortality, a way out of here. I don't care how crazy it sounds. A way out of Rapture's music to my ears. Next Sunday morning, I'll be there.
So the way out of Rapture is sadly by sacrificing your own life. So just leaving dead. Well, not really leaving, but you're dead. You just sacrifice yourself for the family. And Wales is hiding out in Siren's Alley, preaching. as some kind of, well, preacher. So a religious man. But with that said, I'm going to take a little break right next to this corpse. So you're going to know what we're going to start the next episode with. But with that done, I'm going to take a little break. So thanks again, Anomsi, for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on the YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye! Yeah,